Hello and welcome back to some more Long War of the Chosen and Long War of the Lack of Missions, I guess.
Advent forces are in the process of airlifting a number of supply crates out of this area, and we have an opportunity here to take a few for ourselves. Locate and mark the crates with transponders, and Firebrand will handle the rest.
Right, we've got 5 people here.
I'm still here.
A little bit of a smash and grabby mission. Okay, yeah, this kind of map. Alright, cool, cool, cool. Get you up on the high ground. Oh, yeah, Mooney, hopefully getting a promotion here. I want to see what's in that second shop here. You go there. Owl.
Confirmed coordinates.
Move the center here.
You in a hurry, inmate?
Yeah, we've got 7 to 9 enemies. We've got the Lost here, obviously, because it's a Lost City. And we've got the first crate all the way back here. So there's probably some more stuff on the side. I've had situations where we had the first drone somewhere over here, which really makes for awkward first encounters.
Nearing strike range.
Tab. It's actually go there.
What?
Take our last spot. Gonna be so far behind. Now, if we fight on the right side, then this balcony here is not a terrible position to be in. Right on the left, then you're completely out of position over there.
Headed there now.
At some point I need to kind of keep track of how many turns until the first lost group shows up, because at that point you kind of want to engage the enemy.
Through here.
Slow, Mooney, yes.
Heading out.
Closing on target.
We keep seeing absolutely nothing.
Fine.
Judging by the last time we did this mission, we went really, really deep further in there, right? This is barely half the map. So I think getting the sniper mech closer is the right choice here. Ideally up here.
Will do.
Let's get you in there. There's actually no lost turn, no the loud sound, combat, draws lost closer.
I see him. On the same page.
Now, I don't have any fantastic opening.
Double time it.
No trench gun, no flamethrower.
In motion.
All right, let's get you over there. I'm assuming they keep walking this direction, so they'll be here next turn. We've got the shotgun right next to them. Got the akimbo out of position.
A clever ploy.
Say, what I would call it, but sure.
I depart.
Anything over there? Okay.
Come on, let's go.
Get you in there. You there, and I think we go in here.
Heading out.
You absolute useless advent junk. Disgrace for the Advent gene pool.
This one's mine.
How dare you? The drone is, of course, coming this way. We can't even go after them. Need everything about this right now. But, of course, go in there. Which seems totally reasonable, right? It's just, yeah, what up? Just here to mutilate you. By Mr. Bio Rocket Trooper. 6 to 19 damage. And hopefully get a panic on the other guy. And then probably not have a shot with our mech at all. Unless we fire a rocket. Akimbo was probably not in position. You can maybe do something with you, maybe have a run and gun available. And reactivate whatever else is back here. Alternatively, I mean, got the mobility, right? Do I care about those guys being jackasses? Not really. I can get all the way over here. Only one who's gonna have a bit of a hard time getting close enough is you.
Certainly gonna put in a good word for you if we make it out of here.
Actually, work on the drone then, I guess.
Pushing ahead.
Now you come over there. out of the site.
Can't wait.
Watch him turn around again to the other side. It's like, I know you're there, I'm not coming. Okay. So I'm looking at, of course, the bio rocket trooper is in a position that I can't really attack. Or rather that I don't get the damage reduction because he's not active, he's not actually taking cover. Did I not give you any ammo? We shoot that guy, we intercept. Let the drone come, kill it with shotgun, and you kill the trooper. A little bit concerned about the intercept. Maybe you don't intercept, but rather manually just kill somebody. Beautiful camera work. Don't see that anymore. Target disabled. Actually, she departs, and so do you.
Just how many people do I have to kill to get a legendary to drop? And I suppose
who asked
one
you?
More won't hurt.
I will not be stopped.
Apparently, you, Lee, you've just been stopped.
Rubber's on the road, and the kids are in the back seat. Nothing's moving down there.
Alright, so I guess we gotta do that then. Two additional tiles. Let's hope we don't activate anything. Casual 19 damage, critical. That's a tough pill. Not here. To go home with only 11 crates, right?
These mutons seem a little more agile than the ones we fought in the past. It looks like they're still serving as the aliens' front line, though. Good work. Advent's locator is down and our transponder is active. Firebrand will handle the pickup.
You still do area grenades, so okay. But I guess the senator here? much of a hitchy, he says. Alright, we need to mark crates. We need to help our buddy out here. And I think we're just gonna hope that we, if we kill this thing, maybe Gore panics the captain. As well, enrage here. 88% only to hit. What you gonna do about it?
Do you really need this?
No. No gore. Okay. Now, we had some issues, I think, last time with this kind of position. It kinda wasn't really providing cover. You know, I'm gonna run back all the way there. Got that ability. Get addicted to that.
There's not much time.
Need to front evac, but we have also, we've got some time. You know, she just said there's not much time, but you know. Lost Swarm. Maybe one of them goes towards the Harrier, maybe two.
Get down here! Not fair if I have all the fun.
Firebrand is on deck for recovery. Keep marking those crates, Metis 1-5.
Not sure that's the play here. Now, I know one thing that's the play, and that is making sure we can evac.
This is Firebrand. Evac request confirmed. Hold tight.
The path leads this way.
That's also one guy in there. I don't know what kind of guy it is.
Drinks are on me.
Since we didn't get the kill here, you're not even reloaded.
I'm on the move.
So let's move you up and reload.
Rock and roll.
Still easily amused, I see.
I don't like raw. It's like, why couldn't you grapple to that tile? Oh, but I got implacable. You know what? It's fine. You ran to the side, so the other pot is somewhere over there, I guess. No, we gotta do this. You'll see the grappler from here. No, you don't. Yes, you do.
Speak quickly.
I will not be stopped.
two grapplers, both running towards Advent. Okay. Well, that's a crate. Why do they all get actions here? Even Natalie can't reach that. I mean, there is a way. There's a time, there's a situation where Natalie can actually reach that. Something with basically having Owl, but Bansif somewhere over here. She attacks something over here. And then, you know, conduits to him and gets that. Man, that's... How do we do this? I think I just have to, like, run in here, blue move, activate. See where they move, then I can run a gun, react to this.
Approaching target now. Get down here! Not fair if I have all the fun!
And that's the map also, right? Yeah. Well, there they are. What's my mobility? 12, 8 tiles. So if I grapple here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Not getting where I need to go. Purifier there. Okay. That's the only thing you can reach back there. Wouldn't it be nice to have combat presence right about now? You reach everything. What does it cost? Half your damage. I doubt that your rockets reach that far. No. Okay. Gun here. Stun gun this guy. But how do I get you closer? How do I get an enemy closer? So if I grapple here. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. What if the purifier doesn't explode? Right. Let's just put it this way. This is very, very likely to kill the purifier. Do I get my free move though if I do that? How does that work? Melee attacks. Attack an enemy with move range. If using empty second, the move action is granted for a melee attack. It's a melee attack. Alright. If he explodes, I'll take a little bit of damage. Well, if he doesn't explode, because he doesn't even die, I don't take damage. Fantastic. Not fantastic, actually. So just move there, I don't have to work with conduit. You can... I don't even know what you can do. It means Logical can finish off the Purifier.
Need to get a closer look. Kill confirmed.
Is this the mission where I'm finally too greedy? Because I'm leaving three people uncontrolled here. Biotrooper, Duelist, and the Harrier. Well, probably uncontrolled, right?
Get down here! Not fair if I have all the fun!
Now, let's get as close as possible.
Affirmative.
Good, one person already in low cover. Might as well be two then.
He's down.
I think he is.
No joy here.
Right. Well, you had two people out of cover. How about three people out of in low cover?
Still easily amused, I see.
I'm not sure of actually getting some damage in against the Harrier.
Push ahead.
So part of the reason why I'm so willing to take all these risks here is just really the fact that we don't have any missions right now. So if a bunch of people get injured and are out for 2 weeks, who gives a damn? We have the whole roster available. Now, of course, nobody should die. Be very advantageous.
Here.
Okay, there's my first wound.
We're getting eaten up here.
Could you stop all attacking the same guy? You double moved. What's happening here? Okay. Can get a flank on the biotrooper. But you could also kill the Batman. Can't justice this guy, right? Because he's a big beefy dude.
again?
It's too far away from the duelist. Damn. I didn't check that.
I will not be stopped.
I depart. No.
Well, that's not quite the damage I was hoping for.
I will not be stopped.
Just shoot you with a shotgun here. Alright, so I'm thinking we're going for the power up. And the attack on this guy.
The death of a really mass shall be a treasure forming sacrifice.
When you're thinking that I want to flank this guy just so that he... Alright, you know what? Let's check if you can get the kill here.
Armor still holding.
Oh, okay, so you have to get it.
I got no idea what this thing is.
At least I know I'm not getting Bladestorm or anything like that, but I want to limit the number of attacks he can take, right? Some fairly certain duelists can take multiple shots if they stand still. Yeah, I'm giving him an easy flank on me. Take some damage, be injured for a while, that's fine.
On the same page.
With a 10% stun chance, huh?
Order's confirmed. Moving out.
Alright, what do we got? Dasher, Dasher, Grappler. We also got two crates that I completely forgot about. Oh, are you telling me now that I can't get... What's with the crates on this mission? What is Advent's secret strategy here about marking... Always, this is so much.
Yeah.
Say the bullshit word again, but man, if it smells like bullshit, then it is bullshit. Yeah, gotta leave one of those crates behind. Fairly certain.
Do you really need this?
Yeah, none of you can reach that crate or that crate. So Natalie can kill this Dasher and then move to one of them. To the other one. I mean, it's one crate, right? So we get... Big deal, we only get 11 instead of 12.
Ugh, fine.
But it already feels then the wounds are not worth it.
I'm ready.
This one's marked, this one is still open for taking. Yeah, this one is marked by Advent. Yeah, that's it. Okay.
Let us move. That is impossible.
Standing shot.
Certainly gonna put in a good word for you if we make it out of here. He's down!
I'm out.
Yeah, Bradford, shut up. Don't mention the crate.
Advent just airlifted out their first crate. We're gonna have to move fast if we wanna get the rest.
Got one. Gotcha.
Weapons hot. In motion. Come on! I won't go down without a fight.
I thought for a second he was coming over the rooftop.
No joy here.
You really? That wasn't a double move.
This is Firebrand. It's time to go.
Let's just bash that.
No one else dies by your hands.
Approaching target now.
We could do something like that.
On my way.
Yeah.
Let's into this. Into this. Into that. Into here. Into out.
You're all mine, okay?
All XCOM operatives are secure. Firebrand is returning to base.
With 2 turns to spare before reinforcements show up.
With a mug like that, you might get Advent to surrender after all.
I guess at the end there, I shouldn't have been complaining about the crates. Because those were the only crates left, and the far one, which I couldn't have gotten to either. I shouldn't have marked the crate at the Harrier.
Of Advent's ongoing development or outreach programs. Voluntary citizen emigration numbers are reportedly at their highest level in recent years.
Also, probably an argument to be made to not mark the crate in the evac zone, because, like, I usually mark crate as I move past them, right, so that I don't have to backtrack. And I'm making a lot of gestures here, right, with my hand. But obviously that doesn't apply here. Like, if the crate's in the evac zone, that's not really backtracking.
As if things weren't bad enough between the Elders, their alien armies, and the Chosen, Now we've got zombies to deal with.
On the bright side, got three promotions out of it, and as I said, yeah, out for 2 weeks sucks. Red Rockets, yes. You know, so far I've been mostly playing you as a sniper, not as a rocketeer, but I guess that comes with being on a lost mission, huh? Alright, concentration. Razor's automatic upgrade to normal hits. Would have been really nice against that purifier there. Transposition. And adrenaline, each time you score a kill, we gain a shield. So we all know that invert is really, really good on the Templar, so transposition also seems to me like it's good. What I really don't like right now is not knowing anything about this ability here. Does it cost an action? Does it end your turn? I know it has a free turn cooldown. Single action or free action and non-turn ending? Fantastic. Give it to me, baby. If it ends your turn, complete garbage. Yeah. I'll actually not assign anything here just yet. We've got 2 weeks in the injury bay, and I'm probably gonna ask around if that is turn ending or not. And how many actions it costs. Also, Uni is fixed. I'm still not sold on Leg Short for all the reasons I said the last time with the last Akimbo, so I think we're going with Electrified Spikes. It's 6 supplies, huh?
We've got the schematics, and our equipment is ready to begin assembly, Commander. Just give the word and we'll build the Skull Jack.
That's a quick way to get a few people out of all of the long injury times. Now, I really want to do... just tell me what your options are. Ooh, you can be an assault mech. Like, everything tells me, yes, turn him into a mech. Even he requested it in the comments specifically, hey, I want to be a mech. I really wanted to play with a shooty recon. I guess after losing Hunter's Instinct here, though. Stronger is so nice. I guess, on paper. Don't know how it works, if it actually works. I like the way he played in that last mission, right? The whole hit and run, this one's mine combo. So we get rapid fire. It's a bit like a shooty shinobi, just with already coming active at staff sergeant rank and not just tech sergeant. And first strike being really good. But that being said, you know what? He's out for 33 days. I could turn him into mech, then he's ready for combat again in a few days. Same thing here. We could actually also... We still have was a crash or what? Our assault? We have another assault somewhere. I know that. Dirty. Yeah. Which gun? So, assault mech, again, one of the mechs I think are fairly strong and very much, it plays really very much like an assault, just doesn't have all the skills that an assault has. Comes with a sturdy mech body and a mech weapon that's really strong, right? Decisions. You know, executive decisions, that's what's being asked for here. We're gonna go into the proving grounds. We're gonna build a new mech. And for some reason, I feel that didn't take my supplies away. Or did I have more supplies? Oh, I got the supply thingamabob, covert action in. So we could just go double the assault max. Ah, here we go. Done. Six supplies gone. Alright, talking about supplies gone. You're gonna be gone in 3 days.
Avenger plotting new course.
Pick up that intel, pick up that those supplies here. We are not infiltrating a single mission right now. That's really bad. Gonna get what booster jets with the little supplies we have left. I think so.
We'll get started right away, Commander. I'll send word when the project is complete.
So booster jets are an equipment item. Ooh. Two faceless Russian war slap. What's the timer like? I'm gonna do this in the next episode, even though that's always really short. I think we're gonna have a really long strategy timer in the next episode, and because we don't have any missions infiltrating right now, so we're gonna do that next time. I'm just gonna finish my thought on booster jets. So booster jets are an equipment item that you can give someone. They can then with that leap up on buildings with single action. A sniper can also use that to temporarily gain high ground. So if they're on the same level as someone else, they activate an ability on the booster jet. It hovers them up in the air, they take the shot, they hover down again. So that's cool. They also have an ability, emergency evac. So you can evac the soldier who has the booster jets from any position on the map. That's really nice, like if you have the fixed evac missions where you need to run through the city, you can just leave your sniper back in a sniping position. He supports the whole time with sniper shots, and once the squad reach the evac, they can just evac from their current position. There's also some cheese you can do on covert action ambush missions, but I'll do my best to not do that this campaign. So it's basically, you give all your covert actions a booster jet, and as soon as the ambush starts, you evac them out, and the four guys that came for the rescue are just evacing out since they start on the evac spot. So, a little bit cheesy. Anyway, enough about that. We've got a rendezvous to do. We'll do that in the next episode. Thanks for watching. See you next time.